Okay, guys, so this week I've got something a bit different prepared for you. I've decided to look at one of my infilled videos. This is the one you may have seen on YouTube for many years. It's called Three Closes in a Row. And I'm going to look to break it down for you. Now that you've watched the Next Level Conversations talk, I want you to be able to identify which parts, which elements are in place within each interaction. I also want this for you to be motivation to actually, for you to actually get out there and start interacting. Remember, you don't need to get numbers. You don't need to convert it into dates at this point. You just need to get started, right? You'll be surprised how a simple a look and a hello, how far that can really go. So let's look into it. Oh, that's not the one. Here we go.
Oh, really? I've been there. I have. I was in Riga. It was funny, but they're a bit behind in the times. They need to catch up a little bit on their infrastructure, right? We went to some ghost town, and it was crazy. We went to, yeah, well, it was like barren. There was nothing there. There was nothing there. We went to a shooting range underground near.
Okay, so first of all, like what we need to understand is this, that your body language is always going to be louder than anything that comes out of your mouth. So typically what you'll see me do is I'll look for a situation that can make me come across as most comfortable as I possibly can. Now, in this instance, I've got this beautiful bit of architecture to lean up against. There's a safe talking distance between us, right? You may be familiar with this of the COVID times. You've got to be social distance, good social distance away. I mean, I don't really see why you should be closer than that anyway, really. It becomes uncomfortable if you were close than like 1.5 meters. So what's important here is getting yourself comfortable first of all. Eye contact, right? If eye contact is something that you're not comfortable with, now is the start time to actually start getting comfortable with that and slowing what you're saying down. Now, with this lady here, I saw her, she was looking at something on the wall. So I, and she was, she was tall, she was blonde, and I thought, well, which part of California are you from? So assumption, I assumed she was California, from California. In response, she actually told me that she wasn't from California, she was from Latvia. So remember, if you think about the structure, you've got your open, you've got your assumption, you've got your hook, you've got your challenge. Now, I've assumed that she's from California. Her response is, I'm from Latvia. Latvia is the hook. So when you get a response, you're now thinking, okay, can I relate? Can I relate to that bit of information? If not, can I challenge? Can I get her to tell me something more interesting about that place so I can learn and build chemistry on that? So here you're about to listen to hear me go into the relate section.
A little bit on their infrastructure, right? We went to some ghost town and it was crazy. We went to, yeah, well, it was like barren. There was nothing there. There was nothing there. We went to a shooting range underground near a petrol station. It's crazy. But yeah, well, okay, so tell me a little bit. Why are you here?
Well, I have many reasons.
Well, to meet handsome English gentlemen.
Well, quite a good one.
So how do you know when you found a good one? How do you know when you found a good dude? Oh, really? Where do you feel it?
I believe.
Okay, so in that, oh, let me put my audio back on. Yep, we got on. So in that part there, you can see me posturing, right? You can see me lowering my voice. You can hear me move it towards the direction of talking about emotions. And again, if you've watched Next Level Conversations already, you would have learned about the importance of what you think is what you project. So I could be talking about anything, but really I'm projecting something else. So practice that. You can change your thoughts, you can change how they feel. And that is an example of it at play right there and then.
So how do you
Once
know when
I
you found a good
feel
one?
like I've got the chemistry there, I've got the
How do you know
rapport,
when you found
the
a
next
good
step
dude?
is actually taking a risk,
Oh, really?
right? Taking the risk. What am I going to do? Am I going to go for the number? Am I going to
Where do you
close
feel
it?
it?
Or am I going to see if I
I
can get the
believe
date there and
that.
then? In this
I believe
instance, I go for the date right there and then. You know, I got the camera out with me. Why not? Let's see if we can get something spectacular for you guys
Well,
to
look,
watch.
I've got to go to a meeting in a bit. But what are you? A tea or a coffee? Yeah? Huh?
Cats or dogs?
No, tea or coffee. Which one?
Coffee.
Come on, let's go. I've got 5 minutes. We've got to go. Come.
Okay, and again, like you think about the structure, we've got open, assumption, hook, challenge, time constraint. We've just seen a time constraint in there. I've got 5 minutes. Come on, let's go. And yeah, you're leading. You're not asking her, you're suggesting. And what I kind of did there is a bit of a gave her the magician's choice. Are you A or are you B? Right? Each answer would have benefited the direction we wanted to go. Are you a tea or are you a coffee? I mean, even if you say it doesn't matter, you would have seen in my other videos, a lady says it doesn't matter and you just lead anyway.
Where's the interest? Yeah, where's the interest? It doesn't make sense. Yeah, exactly. My boss is going to kill me if he sees. What am I going to say to my boss? So, sorry, I was chatting up this girl on the street. Yeah, we do have editors. Jesus. Okay, so tell me a little bit, but not too much. My name, Johnny. Okay, beat. Latin? In fact, you are, right? Yeah? Yeah. Oh, what's your second name? Well, how do I say it? Go on. Okay, well, listen, I've really got to rush off. I've got to go. So, this is how we do in London, you know, it's European.
Okay.
Mwah. Mwah.
Have a good day.
Okay, take care.
Okay, so there's a couple of things there, you know, a bit of language. Tell me a little bit, but not too much. It subtly implies that we're going to see each other again. Let's not get everything out on the table right now. There's no fun in learning things about each other so instantly, so quickly. Yeah, that's kind of suggesting that you're a bit more of a serious guy, right? When it comes to the clothes, you know, I said, you know, what's your name? What's your name? First and second. Well, the reason why you do this is because then you can actually do a bit of a background check as well. You could throw the name into Instagram, you could throw it onto Facebook, Google. You know, if you're not doing it, you need to start doing it. It's part of the qualification procedure. We've all been there, you know, 6 months down the line, 18 months. The girl's an absolute nutcase. But you're only yourself to blame, you know, because you didn't really sort of do the checks. And again, you know, you see a time constraint. I've got to go. Remember the graph that I perhaps drew on the board of when's the best time to get out? It's when you noticed a high in the conversation. Remember, we're anchoring positive emotions to the experience, right? Or negative ones. And they'll anchor a negative experience if you've kind of let it kind of fade out. You've hung on to the interaction for too long. What it's conveyed to them is actually that you don't have many opportunity in your life. Therefore, you know, you're trying to really milk the others out of this interaction. So again, it's a subtle thing that's implied there. that you're familiar with these sort of interactions. You haven't reached that level of importance just yet. You know, we're still at the beginning phase. You're not on a pedestal, right? So any guys that have always fallen for that, putting women on a pedestal so instantly, that's what we need to watch out for there. Let's take a look at the next one.
Excuse me.
Okay, so again, the body language here, look at this. This is a side approach. It can be done. You know, approaches that can be done are, you know, front facing, side or sidewards, the run around, but we tend to steer away from approaching people from behind. It's not a strong approach. It's easy to brush off. You're not going to really make impact. And it's quite chasey, right? It's not the look. So I'm often working with clients to help them get this right. And the trick here is this. If you're going to do a side approach, again, you have to make sure there's plenty of distance between you and them. Remember, they don't know what the hell the agenda is. Are you a remaining pickpocketer? Are you a club promoter? Are you a Bible salesman? Like, are you trying to convert them to Islam? Like, what's going on? They don't know. So you've got to give enough distance between you guys. And then when you open, you might want to, you know, walk a little bit with them. But if you continue walking with them, it's going to raise their anxiety and raise suspicion. It's like, oh, what the hell does this guy want? You know, what's he going to do? Follow me back home. We don't want that. So we want to walk. We want to walk, talk, get them invested a little bit, then stop, anchor yourself, 2 feet on the ground. Is there anything else I can do with myself? Can I push myself up against the wall? Can I get out of the rush of the traffic and get us away from this hecticness? Essentially, that should just be a body language rule altogether. If at any point you are feeling uncomfortable with your body language, just stop what you're saying and move the interaction to a safe place.
No, I don't want to be rude. I just literally saw you over there and I thought I'd at least come over and say hello.
Hi.
I know. It's random. I thought it's a new year. I'd be a bit more confident approaching people this year.
Just going to stop this video here. Like, if you're liking everything what you're seeing right now, do subscribe to this YouTube channel. And also, you know, give us a thumbs up and check out our programs. If you want me to actually analyze your footage, you can actually send that in and I'll do that for you. Okay. Look how honest I am in this interaction. Remember, it doesn't really matter what you say. What matters is what you say in response to their response. I'm just putting the game on the table. I'm saying, oh yeah, you know, I saw you there. I thought I was going to be a bit more confident this year at approaching people. Nothing cheesy, nothing, you know, you're not overthinking. Just if you can't think of anything, just say what's in your head. Say what is going on. Be honest, be direct, put them at ease.
What's your name?
Holly.
Holly, Johnny. So I've got to rush because I'm on the way to work. So what's the story quickly? I mean, what? Don't tell me too much, just a little bit.
About me?
Yeah.
There we go again. Don't tell me too much, just a little bit. And also, you'll notice in this interaction that I'm doubling up time constraints. You know, I'm in the present moment, guys, right? I'm in the present moment. I'm reading what's going on in front of me. It's like, okay, she's looked over her shoulder once or twice, right? So she's indicating that's the direction she wants to go. So I have to use a time constraint now. You hear me say, look, I've got to go, but quickly. What's your story? Like, I'm interested. Like, I'm using the I'm jumping on the time constraint and use it to my advantage.
Well, don't tell me too much, just a little bit.
About me?
Yeah. All right.
That's
but...
about it, around the corner.
Don't give too much away. I prefer, like, it's better to learn about each other.
How about you?
What do you think? You had a guess.
What do you do?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay.
I'm really bad.
I'm a writer.
Are you?
Yeah.
What do you write?
All sorts of stuff, but I don't want to tell you too much.
The really important thing to get right, guys, is like you can't give away too much. Like genuinely, you can't give away so much at the beginning. But if you give away nothing, right, you're going to make them feel uncomfortable, and you're going to feel like they've, you know, they're going to feel that they've gave you so much, but you haven't sort of met them equally on that. So you've got to be aware, like if you've developed a skill in terms of eliciting information from people, you've got to give a bit away, right? You've got to give a bit away, otherwise they won't trust you, you probably won't get a conversion from that.
Okay, look, well, I'm obviously busy, but we should definitely continue this another time.
Okay.
How do we go about it?
Again, a time constraint. I'm obviously busy.
I don't think I'm allowed.
I mean, even my boyfriend's gonna kill me.
Yeah, exactly.
You know?
So here's where it gets interesting. Like, clearly this lady was, a level of interest had been developed here. She mentions she's not allowed, right? However, everything about her in this interaction is saying, I am interested. You know, her body language, her legs are crossed. And what I say, I've shown this video at my workshops to my students before, is that the body language was saying yes, but the mind was saying no. And I genuinely do believe she did have a partner. And I had to find a way with language to be able to get her details without the guilt attached. And you'll see how I do it right now.
But I think sometimes you've got to just break the rules.
No, you can't. You've got to be good.
Holly, what is it? 07 or 075?
I can't.
Why not?
I'm not.
Why? What? Who's gonna get in trouble here?
Me.
Why?
You've got
rumbling around with all these excuses in your head. Come on. Okay, well look, you take your number, and if shit goes wrong with your boyfriend,
always,
you can be like, hey Johnny, I need to pick me up. Come and let's have some G&T somewhere. You know? What are you talking about? You can't.
Anyway, I gotta go, but
Oh Holly, that's really embarrassing because we're obviously gonna bump into each other around here. Okay. Well then we should accidentally bump into each other, but we should. Yeah, but we need to like fabricate this. Come on, what are you doing? What are you talking about?
I've got to go.
Or email address, something. Come on here. So we can keep it platonic.
Email address,
you can have that. Yeah, alright. Okay.
So there you go, guys. Look, it's the anxiety rises from thinking that, you know, she's going to get a text from me at some time while she's there with a partner or boyfriend or whatever. So, you know, you had to find a way that was, you would be able to operate under discretion. So that's why the email was the best kind of option there. And the unlock piece of language there was keep it platonic. Okay, there's no guilt attached to that. Like, yeah, his person is keep it platonic. He just, he's a friend. And anyway, you shouldn't be going after taking women anyway. You know, when you've got this skill, there's just no need to. There's so many options out there. You don't need to be playing that game. Okay. This was just I was typically doing this to show you how to navigate round hurdles.
Yeah, all right. Okay. Put it in there. Doesn't any feel. So it's South London, right?
Where I'm?
Yeah, your accent's South London.
I'm actually from Southampton.
Oh, okay, okay.
It's south, you're in the right direction.
It's a nice escape, Southampton.
Yeah.
Oh.
It's lovely. Are you from London then?
Just outside, actually. Reading, do you know?
Reading, yeah.
Oh, you do?
It's underwater at the moment.
It is, yeah.
Yeah.
Holly, what's your second name? Okay.
Anyway, obviously I'm late, so
Holly, lovely to meet you.
Wow.
Wow, be in touch,
okay?
Yeah, and you, darling. Take care. I just literally see you over there and I had to come over and at least say hello. I know, it's ridiculous.
I love this approach, right? I used to come, I saw you over there and I had to at least say hello. There's some magic in the language there. When you receive that language, you know, just because the phrase at least is in there, it's almost like, oh, okay, no, at least I'll listen to him. You know, it's very subtle. But again, look at this approach. It's someone coming directly towards me. So I've said it before and I've said it many times, and I say it again, is that most interactions start before you opened your mouth. So, you know, don't have your head looking down, have your head looking up. You look out the windshield, see what's incoming, right? And look and smile. And simply, a lot of interactions can start with just like, yeah, okay. As if, yeah, you've both clocked each other and you're taking it somewhere. Right, but this one was, hey, you know, I saw you over there, game on the table, and I had to at least come over and say hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
Holly.
Johnny.
Nice to meet you, Johnny.
And you're English?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
But your mum's Italian, right?
No, kind of exotic, anything.
I'm trying to get hooks here, right? And I fail miserably at this. She's just not giving me anything. Yeah, and you'll see how I go about it.
Where's this tan from? What are you talking? You've been away over Christmas or something?
No.
I've gone with accent. I've gone for tan. Nothing.
Okay. Well, listen, I've got to rush to work, but I just literally want to. I saw you. I've got to come and say hello to this girl.
Thank you very much.
So we should grab a drink sometime.
Yeah, I work just around the corner.
Where do you work? Thing is, I don't like knowing about girls too quickly. You know, I prefer to learn more organically. Because the thing is, if I just tell you everything about me...
Well, that's very boring.
Right. And so we don't appreciate it. So how do we do it?
Do you have a card with your number on?
What do you think I am? Some taxi phone? what is this?
So that's funny. You've got to really, like, ridicule, like, a silly... You know, a bit of closing language I like to use is, how do we stay in touch? And then, you know, if they give you a silly option, like, oh, do you have a card of your number? Like, it's got to be ridiculed, right? Or, oh, are you on Facebook? Like, what are you, 16? Like, Facebook's fine. Instagram's fine. And, you know, getting a phone number is always going to be the strongest because you've got more in control of the follow-up.
What is this? Holly, what are you? Are you 07 or 075? Come on, let's not mess around here.
077.
You do it here. You're quick, and it's Holly.
With a Y.
No, come on, Holly.
Always getting that second name.
That's good. You must get the piss taken out of you. I realise what it is that.
So she said, I can't say her second name, but she said her second name was, you know, it was funny. It was like, if you went through school, maybe someone would poke fun at you. So I said, oh, wow, you must have got the piss taken out of you. And it, you know, it went down like a lead balloon. She goes, not so much. So I quickly try and switch it up to, you know, spike up some positivity and leave it on a high note.
I like about you now. We have the similar, like, shaped... like face. You know, you got like a square face and then you've got like the round sort of face here. We both have that.
Okay.
You see that?
You've got pretty good cheekbones.
No, we both have a tremendously good face.
Look again, body language. Remember what I said earlier.
Isn't Holly?
It was lovely to meet you.
Well.
Have a good one.
Yeah, I'll be in touch, okay? Take care. Thanks.
There we have it, guys. So you know, there's the three videos. It was 10 years since I did that video. That's crazy. Maybe we should do an anniversary video for that. But hopefully everything you've seen in Next Level Conversations, you can identify it within those interactions. And there's plenty more tips and advice I've sprinkled over there for you as well. Again, guys, get out there. If you're not out there, you're not speaking to people, you're not learning, you're not meeting new people, your social life, your network, it's your dating life, it just doesn't develop. You know, it all starts from the cold approach. So move out of the way of yourself and let's just get this ball rolling. 150 approaches you can do in the next 30 days if you do 3.5 approaches a day. I don't know what the half bit is, but that's the maths anyway. So do 3.5 approaches a day. Maybe the half is like you approach but didn't close it. And yeah, keep it going, man. Keep it going. Like, you know, think about what life could look like 6 months from now, 12 months from now, the next 3 to 4 or 5 years. All right, guys, God bless. And you know where to find me if you want to get some more attention through my live coaching or my private calls. You can reach out to me on the contact form below, or yeah, find a way to message me on Instagram. All right, guys. Bye-bye.